Blood Sugar here, and today we need to do our nails. This is nail day do, and I've been going way too long with my nails looking all kinds of craziness. I don't know what I was doing there. Yeah, but it's all peeling off now. All right, the things that you will need is your fingernail polish remover. I'm just using this because it was cheap and this is what I have. I recommend that you guys use acetone free fingernail polish remover. Brillo pad, because we get shape our nails up. And this is one that I got from a hotel, and I have a lot of other ones. I have the bars like this. I have just the three-sided one. I have a more professional kind. So I have my little cotton swabs to remove my fingernail polish. And the colors that I will be using today is, this is Double Duty by Sally Hansen. This is a base and top coat. I have Significant Other. This is OPI. And for the tip, I have Pure Isis, and this color is called Excuse Me. It's like a really bright yellowy color. This is from Ulta, and it's a really small, pretty maroon color. I do not think that they have, oh, it's called Sunset Bronze. All right, so these are the things that you need. First step is to remove the fingernail polish from off your nails. One thing that I do with my fingernails is, a lot of the time, I don't take off fingernail polish to put on other colors. I just put more colors on top of another one. So I will end up having like several layers on my hand at one time. And the only reason why I do this is because it makes my nails feel stronger. At least the tips feel stronger. And they can just take more stress if I didn't have the fingernail polish on it. So that's why I basically build up instead of just removing and then putting it back on. I decided to shape my nails differently. Most of the time I shape my nails very squarish, but I don't know, I was just trying to do the whole round tip thing, but I don't think I really like it. I don't do any moisturizing of my nails. I mean, this most I might do for moisturizing my nails is whatever they get from me moisturizing my own hair. That's the only moisturizing I would do. I know some people do the whole dip it in oil and hot oil treatments and vitamin E and stuff, but I don't have the resources for that and the time. Alright, so the next step is to clean up the nails, get rid of peeling, get rid of misshaped or reshape the nail to the way you want. You guys, I try to match up each finger with the length. So if one fingernail is a little bit longer than the other one, I will shave it down to the right length. I think it was this finger that broke, and I just cut this, not cut, but I shaved it down. I say shave because I don't really use a fingernail clipper. I just use the filer to shape and, you know, give the length that I want. So the first thing that I do is I get an overall shape that I want. That's just how I do it. And depending on how you like your nail shape is how you're going to shave down your nails. I'm going to do a little, it's not going to be completely square like I've done them before, but it will be more square than I have done them. And I do wear fake nails, but I've never made a nail tutorial with my fake nails on. And some people say, well, why do you wear fake nails if your nails can grow so long? Just because I don't know. It's because I'm stupid. I don't recommend that you guys wear fake nails. They really can screw your nails over and make them super weak. Okay, one thing I will say, how I get my nails to grow so long is I always shave down my nails whenever I see like chipping or split ends. Okay, now when I say chipping, I mean something of this nature. It has layers in it. That's what I call chipping. And that one has a layer in it too. That's chipping. So my nails aren't perfect, you guys. Okay, so I have done all of my nails. I've cleaned them up. No weirdness, no chipping, no flaking, any of that. I've shaped them the way I want them to be shaped. And now I'm going to put on my base coat. Okay, the next color that we're going to do is the OPI color. And I would have to say that this is like my favorite new color. My sister actually got this color, so it's not mine. But I use it all the time because I love it so much. I don't do the whole seasonal thing. I know a lot of people get seasonal colors. I think I'm going to put another coat on. And then I'm going to let that dry for a couple of minutes. Okay, so the next color that we put on after we let this dry is the brassy purpley color. And there's no special technique on putting the color on. Just make sure you put it on as neat as possible. And the best thing that I can tell you when putting on your fingernail polish is to take your time. So let this dry for another
you know, 5 to 10 minutes, and then we're gonna put the next layer on. The next layer that we're gonna do is the bright yellow at the top, and we're doing just the very tip of the nail, leaving a little bit of the burgundy showing. And you can make the burgundy line as thick as you want. The next layer after this is the top coat. I'm not gonna show that on camera, and just know that that is what I did.
Okay, so that's it, you guys. That's the end of the video, and that's all that I do. It's really simple and easy to do, and that's how I maintain my nails. That's how I grow my nails out. I really love to have long nails. These nails at the moment are really short to me. If you want to see how long I like to grow my nails out, there's a link to that video, and I have more tutorials, nail art tutorials. So if this is the first time you guys see me do my nails and stuff, you can check out my other tutorials, and that's the box right there. You can click that and enjoy. All right, so I'll see you guys later. Peace and love.